Cover is slowly fading away, so we're keeping our fingers crossed for some sun, for some nice weather to finish out game two or game four of this four-game two doubleheader between APU and Dixie. So Dixie State retires the out there. 5-3 put out from Danny Barthoff across the diamond, but it does move the runner. So Kayla advances the runner over to second. Jimenez is now at second. 5-3 on the put out with Danny for out number one. That'll bring up Nikki Sprague for Arizona, or Azusa. I want to call them Arizona, but they're not Arizona. It is Azusa Pacific. Shows bunt again, try to move the runner over to third. Pulls back in time, ball one low. The umpires, the home plate behind home plate is Tyler Barfus. First base is Jason Blumel, and third base will be Casey Coleman for your umpires for game four today. That is a base shot over towards Bailey. She sits on a double hop and fields it. The base runner now at third, so leadoff gets on. Second and third batters move her across as the infield doing its job, fielding grounders and throwing them out. Great shot here. It was a good hit ball. Two hops right to Bailey. Doesn't have to move. Throw a glove down, field, and make a play. Now trying to get out Kayla Jimenez. Kayla in game one had a fielder's choice and then a sack fly. And she swings through, strike one. No balls, one strike, two outs. Runner on third is Ileana Jimenez. Brooklyn Beercher looking to get through first inning of work here unharmed. Strike two gets her a little bit of a rise ball as she gets it just up out of the way of the bat. And the sun is coming through a little bit. I can see shadows to my right. Nothing quite yet on the field, but we're looking. We're trying here. And she gets her to swing through it. Strike three. Brooklyn Beercher gets a strikeout. Give her number 59, 60 on the season. She's got 60 Ks this year. And Dixie State goes after the leadoff, 1-2-3. So four batters faced, three retired, and one gets stranded on third for the first inning. So Dixie State will be back in 1 minute with Dixie State's first at bat.
I'm a single mother, and I was the main one working, so I never thought that I could go back to school, you know? My sister, my mother, everybody wanted to help me with my kids. I could not have gotten my diploma without my family.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
Retired school psychologist, and helping people was my thing. After my stroke, when Meals on Wheels started, I was on the other end of the stick, so to speak, and I appreciated it very much, the attention that was given. My name is Julius Gaines, creative writer, poet, photographer. America, let's do lunch.
Drop off a hot meal and say hello. Volunteer by donating your lunch break at americaletsdolunch.org.
Welcome back inside Carl Brooks Field here. Hayden Peterson with CEC TV. And we are on the YouTube Dixie State Athletics channel. So if you're home watching, that's where you're at. You're getting some good video, some live replays, and the rundown, what's going on, called by me, Hayden Peterson. So batting for Dixie State will be Cheetah, Janessa Bassett. In the circle for APU, you've got Kat Ung. Kat Ung on the season, a 1.59 ERA. Great ERA. Unfortunately, she's just a freshman. She's got 4 wins and 3 losses on the season with a 1.59 ERA. That means you're losing some close games. She's not giving up many runs when she's pitching. She's pitched 52 innings, seen 27 strikeouts, only allowed 12 earned runs, only given up 42 hits in those 52 innings. So she's had 10 hitless innings for APU. As she starts with the ball a little bit too low twice to Cheetah, so 2-0 to Cheetah. So she's only walked 17 batters, but she also has 27 strikeouts. She's gone the distance in 6 games that she's appeared in, 13, and she started 9. Too low on all four to Cheetah, and she'll walk. So Cheetah, who only walked 3 times, the last game starts off once again with another walk. Give her a total of 25 walks on the season right now. Once again, Cheetah leads the team in stolen bases. She's 30 for 32. I'm pretty sure she had two last game, but I don't keep the official book, so she only got one according to the stats. Oh, no, she did have two. She started with 28. She got up to 30, so she did have two. They gave them both of her. And she looks like she's going to take off. It doesn't. They throw back to her. Not in time. She's standing on the bag when they make the tag. 2-0 to Danny Barthoff. Two balls, no strikes. After a four-pitch walk, six straight balls thrown by Kat Ung. Another lefty. That one a little bit too high. Kat cannot find the strike zone yet. Three balls, no strikes. 3-0. The defense for APU. In left field, you have Ileana Jimenez. Center field, you have Aubrey Moreno. Right field, you have Emily Moran. Pitch inside corner, called strike that time. So three balls, one strike. Danny Barthoff now going to have to go to battle. In the corner, the hot corner over at third, you have Aaron Jaramillo. Kayla Bouchard at second. Nikki, the other half of the middle infield. Kayla Bouchard at short. Nikki, the other half of the infield at second. And Kayla Jimenez. Oh, strike two called. Danny thought it was outside, dropped the bat, and started headed for first. Come back, try again, as Kat Ung has worked the count full here on the second batter of the day that she has faced. Danny thought it was a little bit too far outside, and she went out. She got a little aggressive heading first. The umpire brought her back for that one. So here's the pitch, payoff pitch. And this time it is far enough outside, and she drops the bat and calls it good. So Danny walks on a full count. That pitch that was called a walk looked like it was almost in the exact same spot. So Kat Ung, with 17 walks on the year, comes in, throws two straight to start, so she now has 19 walks. And now Mallory Paulson will look to try to get Dixie State started early again. Once again, last game, game three of the four, they put up 9 runs in the first inning. That one's called strike on Mallory. 9 runs in the first inning last game, as Dixie State did everything they could to put that one away early. Mallory leaves one up top. One ball, one strike. Speed all over the base path right now. One at second, one at two, one at one. And they show bunt, the ball in the dirt, and all runners stay put. Two balls, one strike. Changeup came off of Kat's hand a little weird that time. And it's kind of hung up a little bit, didn't quite get where she wanted it. So Kat, I'm going to throw a 2-1 delivery. Outside corner for strike. Two balls, two strikes, evens the count. Dixie State batter, I don't know that I've seen one swing yet. Cannot remember if Danny took a swing or not. But it's two strikes on Paulson. Paulson lets one go across her chest. Three balls, two strikes. She's got to come. So she's had a four-pitch walk and then worked her count full on the next two batters, Danny and Mallory. We'll see what she does here. Mallory pops one straight back into the crowd and off the roof of the concession stands and brought back into play. So we'll see the payoff pitch one more time here for Mallory Paulson versus Kat Ung. As Mallory tries to stay red hot, once again, she was batting 444 coming into the game. Bumped that up to 446. That ball's going to be up towards the shortstop, and left field calls her off and makes the play. So Mallory Paulson is retired on the pop out to the left side for out number one for Dixie State.
At the plate, the catcher number two.
Just missed it, and she got a little bit too far under that one.
Jessica Gonzalez.
And that'll bring up the power hitter, cleanup, number 12, Jessica Gonzalez. Still looking for her first hit of the day. She's batting 366 on the year, 34 ribbies. Tied for first with Bailey Gaffin on the team. As first pitch called ball. Second pitch fouled straight back, 1-1. One ball, one strike, one out. Runners on first and second for Dixie State here in the bottom half of the first inning. And my paper is just about blew away. Luckily, they stayed put. Caught a break there. Jessica Gonzalez hits one up to me. I'm not worried about it. It's way over my head. Off the roof and out of here. So one ball, two strikes. Jessica Gonzalez, once again, in all three of her at-bats last game, or two of the three at-bats, she worked her way to two strikes. So we'll see what she does here. Readjust that shoe again and gets ready to go. Jessica Gonzalez swings through one, strike three. So Kat Ung wins that battle this time for out number two. And the first two get up, the next two go down. It'll be up to number double zero, Kenzie Sawyer, to see what she can do. Try to move the runners over and try to get some runs in. Kenzie hits one, and first base is going to retire in foul territory, and that'll work for out number three. So Dixie State gets two on and then leaves them both right where they were. Dixie State strands two. So we'll step aside for one minute, and we'll be back with the inning number two.
Hey, Gabby, how you doing? How was the play date and sleepover?
Dad, it was great.
Awesome. Okay, I'm on my way.
Hey, guys, what are you doing?
We're going swimming.
We're going biking.
Yeah.
I'll see you in a little bit, guys. I love you.
Hi, babe. How was school today?
Hi, Dad. It was great.
Okay, honey, I'll be home soon. Remember, you're never too far away from your kids to be a dad. Reach out and take a second to check in, because sometimes the smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life.
It is a good day to be alive in the STG.
You would have lost your mind!
I could not believe he didn't.
Southern Utah's connection to the world of sports is Sports Radio 97.7 ESPN. Southern Utah's home for the best in sports includes local high school games, Dixie State University, the NBA's new look, Utah Jazz, plus the best of the National Football League. With the worldwide presence of ESPN, to the Devin Dixon Show every afternoon from 4 to 6.
Excuse me as I about sneezed, but I had to pull away the microphone. But Jenna Gorman now going to lead off for APU in the second inning. Allergy season is upon us down here in St. George, and they have been terrible as they've been eating me alive. So first pitch swung on and hit foul, 0-1. Jenna Gorman facing Brooklyn Birchshire for the first time today. Jenna in the first game had a line drive and a pop out to the third baseman, Danny Barthoff. Bailey's at second. And that one's going to go a little bit farther to the right, and that'll find Josie. Josie retires it with two hands and one down. So Brooke with two pitches, one out, as she gets a pop out to the shortstop. Josie, one down.
The third baseman, number 10, Aaron Jaramillo.
Aaron Jaramillo going to step up to the plate. Take her first hacks at a Brooklyn Birchshire pitch. First one fired down in and low, ball one. Then Brooklyn will lean back and fire pitch number two to Hermio. Steerack called on the floating change as Aaron decided to lay off that one. Came across pretty tall, but it was just enough for the umpire to call that one. Steerack, two. Swung through and missed. And Brooklyn gets her to pop up, and Josie calls him off again. Same, almost exact same spot. Pop out to the shortstop one more time for out number two. Take a look at the replay. Brooklyn throws it, gets her in on the hands, unable to get the barrel of the bat all the way through in time. Unfortunately, pops it straight up in the air for APU's out number two of the second inning. Now, that'll bring up number 16, the right fielder for APU, Emily Moran. Swings through the first one, strike one. Emily batting 197, just a freshman, 71 at bats, 13 runs scored. She's got 14 hits to her credit, two doubles. And she also has three RBIs. Second pitch not there, so ball one. One ball, one strike. Dixie State has two outs in the top half of the second inning here. Shows rhythm and then turns and wears one off the shoulder. Not the first time she's been hit today, so she's wearing another one. That time, not much to protect the hit as she takes it right off the back of the shoulder. The last time she took one right off the elbow pad, great spot to take one. But that one's going to go right under the shoulder. Kind of makes my shoulder hurt after shoulder surgery a little bit. I don't want to get hit there by a fastball, not at all. So this will be Ariana. Takes first pitch called strike from Brooklyn. Emily down at first. And Ariana in an 0-1 count. Swing and hit out towards the van. And it goes foul. My paper's trying to blow away again. The wind is picking up a little bit. That one way up top. Ariana fights it off at her eyeballs. Does a great job to get a bat on that and live to see another pitch. So Brooklyn tried to get her go with a rise ball, and she caught up to it all the way at the top of that pitch. It goes outside corner, low, not there, ball one. I also had a baseball update for you. At one point it was 3-4, top of the seventh, with two outs for Dixie State as they're chasing one run. Let me pull it back up for you and we'll see if we can't figure out. That one going to stay in play long enough? It does not. Jessica Gonzalez gives chase to the net but stops there as it will make its way over the fence and to the fans. So Ariana still battling. One ball, two strikes. Staying alive in there. And my phone is cruising. It's going so fast up here with this internet. We'll get to the score in 1 minute. Maybe 2 minutes. Baseball team is also on a doubleheader over there. And I think they're on Radio Dixie with Darius Matthews and Donald Glover. Point Loma is threatening. They've got runners on second and first in the top of the eighth with one out. They do lead still 4-3, top eight. So Dixie State. And there's a shot right out towards center field, but there's a girl out there and she's named Cheetah. No problems corralling that one. She holds it, hauls it in for out number three. And another scoreless inning and no hits for Caitlin Beershear. So we'll take a break after this highlight brought to you by Cheetah. And we'll be back in 1 minute for Dixie State, home half of the two.
I take the road less traveled, run free, unwind, unravel. Someplace outside with lots to do. Green trees, red rocks, and don't forget that blue sky. The sunshine shining, fun shine, pouring on me. Think I might just stay a while. Say hooray all day because the sun is gonna shine on me. Sun is gonna shine on me. Sun is gonna shine on me.
Did you know dragging chains can spark a wildfire?
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Cat Hung returns to the circle for APU, number 23, as she has given up no hits. She walked the first two batters of the game and then took control of 3, 4, and 5 and shut them down. That'll bring up number 5. Sixth in your lineup, Bailey Gaffin. She watches the changeup go low for ball one. The umpire thought about calling it and then decided against it. So ball one to Bailey Gaffin. Ball two to Bailey Gaffin down in the dirt as well. Great snag there by Gorman. Bailey Gaffin, like I said, 4-0-4, and a one-handed deflection there by the crowd, saving lives out there. Great deflection there by the defense. 404 on the season, Bailey Gaffin. 44 hits. That's one shy of a team leader behind Mallory Paulson. Coming from her sophomore. Let's not forget Bailey Gaffin, just a sophomore. And she's almost leading the team in hits for a team that hits the ball really well at Dixie State. She watches one in the ground, and it hits her in the foot, I believe, so she'll take her base. Nice turn, turned the bottom of the foot over, took it off the bottom of the cleat, and took her bag. Oh, we got her right in the calf, so she almost got the foot up and high enough, but not quite. So Bailey Gaffin takes one off the calf. Rolls right into it, just like you're supposed to, wearing one for the team. And Bailey Gaffin will be waiting at first as Shelby Young will try to move her. Shelby Young shows bunt and pulls back, and then they throw down a second and not there in time. Strike called. So 0-1 to Shelby Young. That ball's too high. Oh, that one hits Bailey Gaffin. She's been hit twice in this inning. Once by the pitcher, once by the catcher. Kind of had a frustrated look on her face, like quit throwing it, trying to throw down. You're not going to pick me off. I'm not taking that big of a suicide lead right here. As she turns and wears that one right in the back. If she would have deflected the other way, she'd have been going great. But she wasn't. I can hear the Sweet Caroline coming from Dixie State, so I imagine they got out of the inning. And Shelby pops it up, and now she has to go back. Bailey Gaffin, great piece of base running. Shelby's bunt straight in the air and caught by the first baseman. Hustle over there on play, and Bailey Gaffin with a heads-up base running stays put at first. Gets back in time, luckily. As you see this bunt, just get away from Shelby. Drops it into the barrel, unfortunately. And then the first throw to first, not in time, as Bailey Gaffin with a heads-up running gets back on play. It's bottom of the eighth over the baseball game. No outs, no runners on. First batter seen right now. So we'll keep you posted there. See if Dixie State can't pull it out. They did win two yesterday against Point Loma. They would love to take all four, though. Dylan File, a local St. Georgianite here, had a great day yesterday. That ball's going to be too deep to right field. Oh, diving catch, but it's on the ground. It is not a catch, so Bailey's going to be out at second. The ball did come out of the glove. That is the correct call. Tough break there for Dixie State as Bailey could not see it fall out of the glove. I had a great angle from where I'm at to see it, but on the field it would look like a trap. On this replay, you might even think it's a catch. It's going to be tough to see it come out of the glove here, but from our angle, you can see the ball come out. Looks like a great catch there, and then you see the ball laying on the ground. So just a tough break there for Dixie State. As that'll go in as a hit, I imagine. We'll see what they officially score it. I'm not sure what they're going to score it as. Number 22, Brenna Hink. So Brenna Hink's going to check in and run. All they've got on the scoreboard so far is an error.
At the plate, the shortstop, number 15, Josie Hartman.
So they haven't put anything up yet. I'm going to give it a hit. The ball fell. One ball, no strikes to Josie Hartman. So Brenna Hink in to run. And Josie Hartman batting, 1-1. Josie lays on, swings at one, and fouls it straight back. One ball, two strikes to Josie. She's right on it, just barely missing there, just a little low. Leaves that one up and throw down. Brent Hink back with plenty of time to spare. Dives back just for safety, but she was there all day. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Twos are wild right now. And Josie Hartman swinging away. Swung on, right back up the middle, hit it where it comes from. Absolutely, Josie Hartman right back in the middle for a base hit. Base hit single from Josie, back to back. hits, and the runners are on first and second, bringing it back up to the plate. Your leadoff, number one, Janessa Bassett. That ball just right over the top of pitcher's head, Cat, unable to get a glove up on it in time. And it goes through for a base hit. Now we've got the sun. The sun is out. The wind is back. Welcome back to St. George Dixie State softball. Playing under the sun, not the rain. What a great day. Outside, Cheetah has not seen many pitches to hit all day long. She technically doesn't have an at-bat on the day. As she walked three times the first game and once already this game. And now she swings at one. It's going to be a floater out towards left, and left field's going to come in and retire it. So Dixie State goes down in the second, scoreless as well, with a pop out to the left side for Cheetah to end the inning. One time look at it. The hand's just not getting there in time. Brenna Hink from second moves on over but unable to score. So Dixie State goes down in the second, scoreless as well. 0-0. We'll be back in 1 minute.
So, I just moved in with his family, and it's embarrassing. The little one, he likes to go outside and crawl around in the giant litter box. I don't know what he's doing. I mean, I was born, and I knew how to use the litter box. Look at that. That's disgusting. Oh, poop already. You're making me nervous. Oh, okay, I can't look at this anymore. I really hope he grows out of this, for his sake.
There is a place where rocks bleed, and nature blushes on a battlefield green with envy. Where dimples determine destiny, and a tiny wooden teeth holds the outcome in the balance. There is a place where friends are opponents, and opponents are friends. Where the prize is elusive, the conquest is captivating, and the score isn't settled till the drinks are down. There is a place.
Aubrey Moreno going to get things started here. The number nine hitter going to turn the lineup over for APU here in the top half of the third inning. Seeing if there's any changes from the coach. He'll come over and report them. Maybe. Nope, we're just going to clean the plate off and we'll be underway. As Aubrey Moreno steps in, the sun is out and bright. I'm dressed for winter. And it's getting warm. Aubrey Moreno, inside corner, not enough. Ball one. So Brooklyn Beardshear and Kat Ung both throwing great so far. 1.31 ERA for Beardshear, 1.59 for Kat Ung. Could be a game tough to find runs here. And Moreno sends one through the gap to the right side. Brenna Hink going to scoop it and throw it back in. Gaffin with the cut. So Aubrey with the leadoff single. Nothing new for APU, as the leadoff batters have been doing this all day long for APU. In fact, I want to say the leadoff runner for APU got on every inning but the last two, last game. So 1, 2, 3, they all got on. That one's going to be fouled off straight to the ground. Aubrey Moreno cruises over to second, and now she'll get a cruise on back. 0-1 to the leadoff, Ileana Jimenez. Ileana reached on the error. And one hit given up by both pitchers so far. The ball up in the air. Brooklyn trying to get her to bunt one up in the air. See if they can't make a play, but they're unable to do so far. Brooklyn with the second pitch, and the button's laid down perfectly. Danny's got to scoop a throw in time on the out. So Paulson stays home this time, gets the out. Great bunt there by Ileana to move the runner over, but a better play by Danny Barthoff to scoop and throw. With the quick hands she has coming from second, the quick hands come with her all the way over to third, gets it over there just in time. It was close, but Ileana does not make it. She'll be thrown out on the 5-3. Moves the runner over, though, and that's one out. It's runner on second, and it'll bring up number two, the two-hitter Kayla. Number one, the two-hitter Kayla Bouchard. She did not go check swing, so ball one. Kaylee Bouchard slaps one down the left field side, goes foul over towards the dugout. 1-1. That ball straight up in the air and backwards. One ball, two strikes. Over to Josie. Josie can't get it out of the glove in time. And that'll go down as an error, I think, to Josie on the E6, and it does. Kayla Bouchard reaches the E6. So runners on first and second, one out.
The second baseman, number four, Nikki Sprague.
Nikki Sprague gonna step up, number four. Ball one up away for Brooklyn. She's now gonna have to have the help behind her with her defense. Ball's on, runners on first and second. That ball hit out towards Shelby Young, going to give chase, and it's gonna land foul. That one tailed quickly and hard. Luckily for Dixie State, it stayed foul, because that was a great shot down the line by Nikki Sprague. Almost sprays one into play, which would have scored a run, maybe two, for APU to get started here. So long strike is all it equals out to. 1-1, one out. Nikki swings and hits up the middle, out of work. Cheetah's going to scoop, and they're going to hold her at third. So the cutoff there to Paulson. Bases juiced for APU after another single for Nikki Sprague. Gets her first hit of, or second hit of the day now. Two singles today. Runners on every single bat, occupying everywhere. And that'll bring up to the plate Kayla Jimenez. Kayla struck out last at bat. But earlier today, she had a fielder's choice and a sack fly. So we'll see what she can do with her fourth at bat of the day. Brooklyn rears back and fires one in there. Kayla goes way up top and gets it, but fouls straight back. Strike one. Kayla Jimenez stand in there. Swings on a changeup way out in front. Great pitch by Brooklyn Beardshire. 0-2. So Kayla fooled. Expecting fastball. Got changeup. Couldn't hold the bat back long enough to find a path for the ball to hit it. Strike two. That pitch too high. One ball, two strikes. Another changeup. That time she gets it. Cheetah's going to get out there. She's going to make a diving catch. They will tag and then throw towards third, and she's going to stay on the base. She'll be safe at third. Scores the run, but Cheetah makes a great diving play to hold the damage to one run. Janessa Bassett, look at this. Get out there and go get a ball. Cheetah goes after it. Lays out, makes a grab, comes up, almost makes a tremendous throw to third to get the runner going there who tagged up. That was Kayla Bouchard, who just about found out what kind of arm Cheetah really has out there in center field. Although it does score the run for APU, Aubrey comes across the plate to give APU their first lead of the day. 1-0 in game two. A check swing, foul ball right over towards me. It's going to be right below my feet. We'll leave it there. Strike one. So Kayla Jimenez That's a base hit in most softball parks when Cheetah's not roaming out there in center. Got robbed. Would have been a huge hit, huge momentum swing as a couple would have scored. Strike two to Jenna Gorman. Two outs now, two strikes, and one run across with the runners threatening only 60 feet away at third. Swung on, hit to the ground. Brooklyn Fields goes home with it and a tag. So they go the hard way, get it out at home, but it works with a fielder's choice. 1-2 put out for the third out of the inning. So Dixie State gets out of the bases jammed, or bases loaded jam, with only one run given up on a diving catch, diving save there from Cheetah. So we'll step aside for 1 minute. We'll be back with the home half of the third inning.
For the Cougars, one run on two hits. No hit, one error.
Wait,
what?
The storks are bringing me a baby brother.
Storks know how to keep kids safe. Do you?
What?
Oh, my gosh, you don't know.
I know.
You don't. Oh, man, you laugh when you're uncomfortable.
No.
Making sure your child is in the right seat is one of the steps to safer travel.
We can do this together.
To know for sure that your child is in the right seat for their age and size.
Remember when I was a baby? It felt like 1 minute ago.
What?
Visit safercar.gov/the right seat.
What he said.
I take the road less traveled, run free, unwind, unravel. Someplace outside with lots to do. Green trees, red rocks, and don't forget that blue sky. The sunshine shining, fun shine, pouring on me. Think I might just stay a while. Say hooray all day because the sun is gonna shine on me. Sun is gonna shine on me. Sun is gonna shine on me.
Sun is going to shine on all of us today. It's coming back out. A little bit of clouds, but blue skies all around. Should be a beautiful weekend here in sunny St. George, where the sun shines 395 days of the year, or something like that. That's what they say. I know it's a lot of days, but that's what they say. So Danny Barthoff going to get things started here in the home half of the third inning for Dixie State as they try to chase the one run given up so far. So the story of the day really has been errors. APU was error plagued in game one of Saturday, and so far Dixie State is the one struggling with the errors here in game two. They've got two of them through two innings. And now Danny Barthoff takes the ball two in the dirt. So we'll keep our eyes on that, see what goes on there. Let's take a look at the baseball game real quick. As Danny Barthoff awaits pitch number three. And that one's across the plate for a strike. And Dixie State, buckle your seats right here. The eighth inning, five runs pushed across so far. Drew McLaughlin grounded out to third base on a sacrifice bunt to move a runner over. Baker advanced to second, and Lucero moved to third on the bunt. So three balls, one strike here to Danny, but Drew McLaughlin has just put two more runners in scoring position with only one out so far. They scored five runs on no outs, and now they've got two more runners in scoring position over there. Danny Barthoff takes a 4-5 pitch walk, her second of the day, and she's on base once more. So Dixie State sends to the plate number 16, Mr. Trey Camachi, the offensive stud for the baseball team. Between him and Drew McLaughlin, there's not many stats left to own for Dixie State all-time offensive categories. We'll see what Trey can do as Trey scores two. And Trey's sitting at first, so he did whatever he did. He's got two across, and Mallory will move Danny over to second with that. But Dixie State blowing it open. They've got seven across in the eighth inning. As you watch the perfect bunt there by Mal. Pick and throw from the lefty. Great job there to get it over. But now you're looking at Jessica Gonzalez, who's been quiet all day, waiting to break out. She hit one to the warning track early in game, or the last at bat in game three, and then hasn't had anything yet. She struck out last time with a strike called here to start her off. So sacrifice bunt moves Danny to second for Paulson. One out, and Jessica Gonzalez takes strike one here in the third inning. Gonzo waits on a changeup, leaves it in the dirt. Ball. One ball, one strike, good pitch there from Kat Ung, changing up the eye level and the speeds. Gonzo leaves that one up a little too high. Two balls, one strike. As Kat Ung trying to stay free on the score column and the scoreboard. Gonzalez leaves another one on the outside edge. Three balls, one strike. With the spot open at first, you may see him move, just put her on, but you don't want to put too many people on in front of Kenzie Sawyer, who has the ability to grab a hold of the ball and send it anywhere in the park that she wants. Gonzalez sees a pitch too low, ball four, so she'll walk. And that's the first time Gonzalez has been on base today with a draws a five-pitch walk as well. And that'll bring up Kenzie Sawyer. Kenzie with one single today so far.
Kenzie Sawyer.
She's the DP today in game two, so we'll see what she can do. Good spot for a designated player to be when you got two runners on. Kenzie watches the first pitch on the outside edge for a ball. Outside corner, no good. Ball one. Kat Ung, number 23, still having quite a day. 1.59 ERA on the year through 52 innings, but you add the three that she's already thrown today, it's 55. She's almost 55 innings in and only given up 1.59 ERA, which is probably dropping with the innings, so she's probably closer to a 1.58 or so, as she has fallen behind quickly now, 3-0. And up next is the red hot Bailey Gaffin, who you do not want to have to face. Bailey is 2-for-3 in game one with two singles. And then she got hit by a pitch already early in game one, or game two today. So she's been on base all day long. Not someone you want to face, especially with the bases loaded. Let's not forget Bailey has a couple of RBIs on the season. And by couple, I mean 34. That one's going to hit Kenzie, and that'll load him for base, the red hot Bailey Gaffin. Bases juiced, second hit by pitch of the day. Goes right off Kenzie's arm. She just, off the inside of the arm, Takes it off the right arm, right in there on the forearm meat. Now it'll be Bailey Gaffin. As she watches first one for a strike, called 0-1. Bases juiced, Kat Ung in a little bit of trouble here for the first time in game two. Bottom of the third inning. Rears back and fires another pitch. Outside edge this time, a little bit too far, not a strike. Ball one. One ball, one strike. Trying to paint lines out there, nothing close. Don't leave a mistake here for Bailey to hit. And she hits one, a little blooper into the middle infield. Should be an infield fly. It is called there by the umpire. A little late on the call, but he got it on the infield fly. So pop out to the six hole. For out number two, now you got to face Shelby Young. Shelby, she is 1-for-3 today, but she reached twice in the first game with an error, and she popped it out to the first baseman on the bunt attempt earlier today. So bases loaded, we'll see what Shelby can do here. Swinging on the first pitch, he's going to go to the shortstop, pick it up and throw it across, and they get out of a bases inning or bases loaded jam. Does APU. So a ground out 6-3, put out for out number three. Dixie State got the runners on, unable to move them across though. So 1-0 APU leads. We'll take a 1 minute break after this highlight and we'll be back with the fourth inning.
So I'm kind of new here, but I've noticed a trend. My human does this funny thing where she goes around and gets all my toys. And then she hides them in that basket by the door. You know, but it's always the same basket, and it's always in the same place. And then she acts so surprised when I find them, but, you know, she's putting them in the same basket. Again. It's like, hello? That's where you put it last time. You were the worst at hide-and-go-seek.
The Dixie State eighth inning over. Baseball game continues as Trey Camachi is on second. Luke Porter is on first. And Bryce Feist is in an 0-2 count right here, trying to extend the inning if they can. Stepping up for APU, it'll be Aaron Jermillo. As Aaron will wait for the first pitch, times it up, and it's a little high. Ball one. So fourth inning to Aaron, her first at bat. She popped up to Josie over at short. She was one of two people in a row to do that. She lays off the second pitch up top as well. Does a great job staying back out of the way of that one. So Jaramillo staying alive, battling right here. Two balls, no strikes. As Brooklyn still unable to find the strike zone. Three balls, no strikes to Jaramillo. And Feist was retired over there. Strike struck out. So they got seven runs on six hits. One inning. Josie from the far side of shortstop. Deep corner. Throws it all the way across for an out. As Mallory Paulson weighted it perfectly. And that'll be out number one. Let's get a good look at the replay. Josie going to her bare hand side. Gets there in time. Okay, takes it square. Throws it all the way across for the out. So 6-3 put out. Aaron Jaramillo making sure Josie gets her fair share of balls today. She's giving her two now. First pitch through Jessica's glove for a ball. So Brooklyn Beardshire still going to work here. Change up right back to her. Brooklyn fields it, grabs it, throws it across. So a 1-3 put out as Brooklyn kind of fields that one. Nonchalantly pulls it out of the glove, turns over, and fires her out at first. Thank you and goodbye. Now batting will be number 20, Ariana Von Zabore. Strike one down the middle. So Brooklyn and Catlin both pitching really well. Only three hits throughout the game combined between both teams. Two for APU, one for Dixie State. There have been a few walks both ways, as well as hit by pitch. One ball, one strike. Ariana leaves that one inside on the toes on the dirt. That's another ball. So two balls, one strike. This one's up, and it'll go foul. It'll go over to the stands. So evens the count, 2-2, two outs. Runners nowhere. Brooklyn Beardshire just fires the 2-2 as right at Josie. Josie going to go off the glove, off the hand, pick it up, throw it, and it's in time, just barely, as she gets her out. So Josie, after almost losing another one off the glove, picks it up bare hand, makes a great throw to get the out.
No hits, no runs, no errors.
Takes a short skip hop right there and got her just in time. And indeed she did. The replay agrees with us. The out was correct. So Dixie State home half the fourth in 1 minute.
Your daughter is having trouble learning French. Do you A, hire a tutor?
Bonjour.
B, enforce a French-only rule at home. Or C, watch some foreign films. When it comes to parenting, there are no perfect answers. But that's okay, because you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Teens in foster care will love you just the same.
There is a place where the sun doesn't hide in the winter, where the greens stay green and the crimson canyons still glow. There is a place where dimples determine destiny, and a tiny wooden tee holds the outcome in the balance. There is a place where we drive for show, putt for dough, and settle the score with another round. There is a place.
And we're back. Welcome back. Bottom four, Dixie State trails 1-0. And it will be batting number 22, Brenna Hink. Brenna in game three from the left side of the plate. Hit a single over second base that ended up scooting past the right fielder all the way to the fence, and she had a stand-up three-bagger on the error from right field. So we'll see what she does here. First pitch called strike right by her as she lets it go. 0-1. Kat Ung still in the circle for APU, as she should be. Throwing a great game, only giving up one hit so far. Doing a great job. Brenna Hink gets a bat on it, just not able to get all of it. Sends it straight back, one ball, two strikes. One ball, two strikes, number 22, Brenna Hink, stands in there waiting for the pitch from Kat Ung. That one's outside, leave it there, two balls, two strikes. Home half of the fourth inning, Dixie State has threatened twice with runners in scoring position, unable to move them. See what they can do here in the fourth. First pitch down low, and it's too low. Three balls, two strikes, and we've got a full count. So Kat Ung with the payoff pitch here finds the one she wants, and she's going to send it. That one goes foul. We'll have another payoff pitch coming at us. That one's going to be a shot out to right center field, and her left center field's going to work. Brenna Hink's going to have a stand-up double, and she will do just that. What a hit there by Brenna Hink, throwing hands out, gets it out there, does a great job. So Brenna Hink does exactly what she needs to do, throws the hands at that one, puts it over left field's head. It was only about 10 feet shy of the fence there, landed right shy of the warning track. So Brenna Hink with a double.
The shortstop, number 15, Josie Hartman.
That'll bring up number 15, the shortstop, Josie Hartman. Tries to lay down the bunt, a little high, pops it up straight back. So Dixie State looking to go small ball here. I like it. Move Brenna Hink over to third, and then any ball Cheetah hits should score Brenna. Brenna not a slow runner as well. She gets around the bases rather well. Josie this time going to try to lay down. This time she does a great job laying it down. Has to field and go to first and move the runner. Sacrifice bunt, Josie Hartman. Great job there, Josie. The runner over to third. Sack bunt for the first out from Josie Hartman. Does what she needs to. Now Cheetah, top of the lineup, going to have to do what they do and produce some runs. Cheetah on the season, 14 RBIs. A chance to improve that number from the leadoff spot. Not a bad number for 14. That is the lowest on the team, as the leadoff batter probably should be. So she's in the right spot. As we may see a change here, coach is discussing with the umpire, and it looks like they might be bringing somebody in. Cheetah will be your batter for Dixie State. Brenna Hink is 60 feet away from tying this game, and there's one out, and they're going to bring someone on to throw. Kat Ung will take a seat for the day. A great job for 3 1/3 innings for Kat Ung. No runs given up. She is responsible for the runner on third, however. And into the game will be 00, I believe. Or 20, pardon me. 2-0, that's a 2. And the designated player, Ariana Von Zabore, is going to be your pitcher.
Attention, please. Now pitching, Ariana Bonspore.
So Von Zabore going to step in and throw. I don't have any stats on her yet. Let me see what I got in my papers. Maybe I have something. Von Zabore with a 3.47 ERA on the year. Win and loss record of 4-3. She's had 10 appearances. She started 3 games. She's gone 38 innings, giving up 47 hits. 27 runs, 19 earned, 17 walks, and 26 strikeouts. So there you have that for Von Zabore. She'll have to face a tough challenge here in Janessa Bassett, who hasn't had a base or hasn't had an at bat all day long, but she's been on base every time with 4 of them. 4 walks, that is. Ball one. Then again, finding a strike zone for Cheetah isn't the easiest thing, as she's not the tallest character on the team. Very aggressive at the plate, though. Ball two. So two balls, no strikes. Cheetah, once again, like I said, she has 4 walks on the day. 4 walks and 1 pop out. So 0 for 1 so far in 2 games. Now seeing her 6th at bat. And strike called on the outside corner. So 2-1 to Cheetah. Runner is on third. That is Brenna Hink. 60 feet away from tying this thing up. See what Cheetah can do with it as she tries to put one in play and give Dixie State a chance to even things out. Cheetah sees one and goes hard down the first base side. It's foul as she was way out in front of it. 2 balls, 2 strikes. 2 apiece here for Ariana and Cheetah in a battle. So Ariana, not only is she their designated player hitting 278 on the year, but she's also one of their better pitchers. And she goes too low and away to Cheetah. So 3 balls, 2 strikes. One place you do not want to put Cheetah is on first, especially with the ability she has to steal. If you have to try to throw down, it might be a double steal, and Hink can get in there and score. So I see Ariana going right at her here, going after Cheetah, make her put it in play. And she misses on the outside corner. Cheetah walks one more time today. 5 walks on the day. An absolute, I don't know what to call it. Rare. Cheetah just kind of has a little slump on her face. Just like, I can't get anything to hit. Now she wants the signs one more time from Randy. If I'm Coach Randy, I'm just giving her the go sign. Go ahead. Go ahead, Cheetah. Got your wheels. Turn them on. Do your thing. Danny Barthoff now. Stepping in to swing away for Dixie State. First pitch up and away, and pulled back down. So Cheetah stays put for the first pitch at least. Ball one. As a pitcher with Cheetah on base, you have to be fully aware that she could go at any moment. Kind of could get into your mind a little bit and make you wonder, is she going or not? And she still just takes that secondary lead. Nothing crazy, but it's called strike. So 1 ball, 1 strike. See if Coach Simpkins tests his luck here and sends Cheetah, or if he just waits it out and sees what Danny can do with the stick. The 1-1 on the way. Danny swung, hit into the gap, and it'll score 2. Cheetah's going to round third. Danny's rounding second. Danny's going to go, and she's going to hold up. Hesitated around second. She'll stay there on 2. As Coach Simpkins yelling towards her, great hit, but he was wanting her to come all the way to third as she was trying to look at the ball, which was behind her a little bit, but a great piece of hitting there from Danny Barthoff all the way to the fence, almost. Oh, it does get through the fence. The right field unable to get a glove on it, but Danny Barthoff with a 2 RBI double for Danny. What a great hit, and Dixie State retakes the lead as Cheetah cruises all the way around from first, easy, and Brenna Hink walks in on third. So Danny with a huge double, and that'll bring up Mallory Paulson for Dixie State. First pitch, Steve Reich on the inside edge. Got him. Great spot there from Ariana. Runner on second, Danny Barthoff, to 2 RBI double. What a great shot out to the right side. And now it's a line drive, caught by first, thrown from her knees. Not in time, though. Safe on the dive back goes Danny Barthoff. So a great play from the first baseman. Look at that again on the replay here. And watch also, there's the Danny hit through the middle, all the way out to the fence.
Number 12, Jessica.
And now Jessica Gonzalez will step up to the plate. Go way over the top, and a pass ball is going to move Danny all the way to third. And now Jessica Gonzalez with a great spot to be. Two outs, runner on third, Jessica Gonzalez, who reached on a walk last at bat. First time on base for Jessica today. And she is due. Sees another pitch too low. Two balls, no strikes. Do not fall behind Jessica Gonzalez if you're an opposing pitcher. She's going to be looking for something fat to hit right here. Inside corner, D-right call. Jessica Gonzalez smiles it off. And she knew she kind of wanted that one, but she'll shake it off. She's still smiling about it. See what she does here. Two balls, one strike. Leaves that one in the dirt. Three balls, and Danny's going to try to score, and she's in. So she scores on the pass ball. Danny Barthoff takes off like a rocket there on third. Clears the plate, so Dixie State jumps ahead. 3-2-1 after the fourth inning so far, but it's not over. Three balls, one strike to Jessica Gonzalez. Look at the speed. Danny all the way home before the catcher could even get to it as it bounced off her chest guard and ricocheted towards the third base dugout. Gonzalez swing and a miss, strike two. Good hack there from Jessica Gonzalez, unable to make contact. Ariana is a powerful pitcher. Like I said, she has a few strikeouts on the year. We'll see what happens here. Jessica Gonzalez has one strikeout on the day, in the first inning of today's game. And make that two, inside corner from Jessica Gonzalez, the catcher who is back there often, so she kind of knows where the zone is better than most of us. But a backwards K to Ariana for the third out of the inning. We'll keep it right here for a couple of minutes while we watch the team warm up. As we're heading to the fifth inning, Dixie State 3, Azusa Pacific 1. The hits are almost equal. Dixie State is a one-hit advantage with three of them. And two hits for Azusa Pacific. Due up for Azusa Pacific in the fifth inning. Let's start right down there on the bottom of Aubrey. Aubrey is the one run across today with a single. So we'll start with her again in the fifth. And we'll go from there. Aubrey, Jimenez, Kayla Bouchard, and Nikki Sprague are due up the next four. So a great pitch there from Ariana. Catches the inside corner. Not much you can do if you're Jessica Gonzalez.
Leading off, the center fielder, Aubrey Moreno.
So Aubrey Moreno going to start things off one more time. First pitch, D-right called. And Jessica Gonzalez, she's expecting that call, especially if she's going to be back there with the umpire after he just rung her up on the inside pitch. 0-1. Strike two. Jessica getting everything she wants back there now as Brooklyn Beardshear works ahead. Two strikes on Moreno. Moreno stands in and slaps it one. Josie going to get under it, settles, two hands, and out. So pop up to short. That's six. That's a one retired. One out in the fifth inning. Dixie State holds on to a two-run lead.
Number zero, Ileana Jimenez.
As you see the replay, just unable to get all the hands on top of that ball. Hands drop just a little bit, pop it straight up in the air. But now back to the leadoff, Ileana Jimenez. Slaps at the one on the ground, first pitch, no good, off the face mask of Jessica Gonzalez. The umpire will claim the plate. Courtesy time to give Jessica Gonzalez a second to get back under herself. And she appears to be not even fazed by it. Took a little soft bounce off of the face mask. One strike. Jimenez reached on an error and then was thrown out by Danny Barthoff so far today. And that one's hit right back up the middle. Beardshear, backhand snag. Yes, sir, got her. Beardshear snags it, throws it across the first as Jimenez is retired again. 1-3 for the second out of the inning. That'll bring up Kayla Bouchard. Kayla Bouchard, 0-2 on the day. Reached on an error and was thrown out by Danny Barthoff over at third as well. There's a strike called, 0-1. Brooklyn Beardshear jumps out ahead once again. And the changeup is slapped away, the tomahawk slap from Kayla Bouchard. That's the second time we've seen that today. A great piece of hitting with the slap there from Kayla. Throws the hands out, waits for the ball, and then hatchets that thing right the last second over third base. Just an excellent piece of slapping for Kayla Bouchard. Two outs. That'll bring up Nikki Sprague. And I can't say enough what a great piece of hitting for Kayla Bouchard there. The hand control is unreal on that slap. Doug, Jessica Gonzalez digs one up, baiting him to go. Staying on the knee, pulls the hand out ready to throw, but no one goes. Not a lot of people run on Jessica. And there's a good reason for it. She has a cannon connected to her right side. Ball one in the dirt, so Nikki looking at pitch number two. That one's a little bit too low for the ump liking as well. Two balls, no strikes. Yeah, you rarely see Jessica actually unleash one when she's coming down. But when the runner does decide to go, it's always fun to let her open up that arm and see what she's got. She has a great pop time all the way down. That same edge that Jessica got called on earlier, not there that time. Three balls, no strikes. Kayla Bouchard on first, and Nikki Sprague with a huge lead here in the count. Three balls, no strikes. That one's right over the edge there. Steerike, one. Three balls, one strike to Sprague. Sprague with a single last at bat. And she was thrown out by second and Bailey in the first inning. That one's low and away, and it'll be a walk. So Brooklyn gives up a walk here, and there's two runners on base now, and that'll bring up Kayla Jimenez. And we'll see what Kayla has done so far. Earlier in the day, she had a fielder's choice and a sack fly in the early game. And we'll see what she can do here. Outside edge, too much. Ball one. Let's not forget, Kayla drove in the run on the diving catch by Cheetah as she was robbed of a hit. There's a strike for Beardshear, 1-1, but Kayla hit the line drive out to right center, and Cheetah made her way over there and just in time to get the out. So 1-1. Kayla lays off the high ball. They look for the back door. No one's there. Gonzo had the arm loaded, ready to go, but no one was covering second, so she had to hold on to it. Two balls, one strike. Swung on, and it's going to be a blooper. It's going to work. Cheetah's going to have to come in and scoop, and she's going to try to throw her out of home, and she's there. Oh, I think she might have got her, but they tell him no, because that was an absolute wrong call. I believe the slide was wide. The tag was on the helmet, and the hand was late. Well, let's take a look at it. That was a great throw from Cheetah. A little high, but it got the job done, I think. As you watch this throw, there's the slide. The foot never got the bag. I think the whole thing was blocked. And the hand came all the way across and got the bag late. And let's see, do we have another angle of the replay? If we do, we'll take it. If not, that's all right. But I think the slide was, she missed the bag with her feet. And by the time that her hand hit where Jessica's leg was blocking the plate, she was out. If we have another angle, we'll take it here. Watch the slide come here. The slide, the feet don't quite get the bag, and then the hand is late on it. There's a strike underneath. Foul ball. Tough to see on that angle as well with the umpire being in the way. But one strike here. Runners on first and second. A great throw there from Cheetah regardless. Kayla gets the job done at the RBI over the middle. Jenna Gorman, the catcher for APU, with a chance to tie it up. Runner in scoring position at second. That is number four, Nikki Sprague. Up top, leaves it there. Does a great job laying off that high one. Change up, right over the top, strike. One ball, two strikes. Down to Danny. Danny off the ground, can't pick it up in time, and everyone's going to be safe. So another error. That'll be number three on the day for Dixie State. And the bases will be loaded for number 10, Aaron Jaramillo. Danny Barthoff just kind of let that one eat her up a little bit, unable to get all leather on it that she wanted. And Brooklyn Beercher going to have to battle out of one here.
Third baseman Aaron Jaramillo.
First pitch called strike. Bases loaded here for APU. Swung on and crushed to deep left field. If it's fair, it's gone. It's foul, foul ball, almost a grand slam for Aaron Jaramillo. Oh, and missed it by maybe 5 feet to the left. That would have been a huge game changer. Would have changed the lead, given a three-run lead to Azusa Pacific as Brooklyn gets away with one there. On a long, long, long strike. And now Brooklyn gonna try to go there. Gets her with a strikeout. So Brooklyn works her way out of it after giving up the longest strike you could possibly give up. She comes back and throws one right by her for strike three. Dixie State gets out of it with the bases juiced and stays in the lead by 1-3-2 for Dixie State. A great job there to battle out of it. Four hits, three hits going into the home half of the fifth. We'll step aside for 1 minute. We'll be back.
Get caught buzz driving, and you could do some hard time.
Craig, knock it off.
Sorry, Mom.
It could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. And that could set you back a few years. Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving. Your son wants to get a cat,
I'll really take care of
but you're allergic. Do you A, prepare yourself, B, make the best of it.
C squared equals
25.
Good job.
Or C, find a loophole. When it comes to parenting, there are no perfect answers, but that's okay because you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Teens in foster care will love you just the same.
Welcome back. What an exciting end there to the top half of the fifth inning as APU loaded the bases. And then Aaron Jaramillo hit one out of the stadium, but it was about 5 feet too far left on the foul pole. And then she comes back, and Brooklyn Beercher wins the battle this time. So Aaron wins the first one, just misses by 5 feet. And then Brooklyn comes back and gets one past her. So Kenzie Sawyer will start things off for Dixie State. And in the circle still is number 20, Ariana. Second pitch, a little bit higher this time, Steve Reich. One ball, one strike to Sawyer. That one's hit a mile in the air. It's still up in the umbrella. Now it comes back down into play in left field under it. Two hands out. It was higher than it was far. A long fly ball, or a high fly ball, to left for out number one. Bailey Gaffin, who made it all happen earlier today with two for three, got hit by a pitch today, and now she popped out of the shortstop. Let's see what she does with her third at bat. That one off the top of the catcher's glove and back to the net. Ball one. Update for Dixie State Baseball. They won game one today by a final of 10-4. Bailey Gaffin fouls this one off to the net, so 1-1. One ball, one strike, one out, Bailey Gaffin. Ariana in the circle. Change up, low and away, too low, two away. So that'll go in for a ball number two. Ball, two balls, one strike. Dixie State holding on to a one-run lead in the bottom half of the fifth inning. Bailey Gaffin fouls one off again, 2-2. Just barely behind that one, not able to get all of it on it. Now Bailey Gaffin going to try to drive through one here. Bailey does so just past the outstretched arm of the diving second baseman. The right fielder keeps this one in front of her and it stays there. So it'll go for a single for Bailey Gaffin. Leadoff does her job and she's on. Right, watch that replay. Get the hands through. Second base just unable to corral it right there. Almost. Almost able to pull it in, unable to do so. So leadoff on Bailey Gaffin. It'll be number 23, Shelby Young. 0-for-2 on the day. Pop out to third, or pop out to first, and a grounder to shortstop. We'll see what she does here in her third at bat of the day, or game three. First pitch inside, ball one. Looked good up here, a little bit inside though, as Shelby lays off for ball one. We'll see what she does here as Ariana goes back and fires pitch number two. Up top and in, Shelby leans back out of the way of it. Ball two. Defense playing straight up. Third is, the corners are in actually. Corners are in and in middle infield playing normal. Shelby Young hasn't shown bunt yet. Still doesn't. Swings away right out to center field and it's going to be right on the center fielder. Good solid contact. Unfortunately, they've got a girl there playing center for APU. That is Aubrey Moreno. Good hit right there from Shelby. Got a lot of it, just not enough of it. Two down on the fly out to center. So Bailey Gaffin got him started here after one out. Shelby answers with a line drive to the middle, and now it looks like Arista Honey's going to check back in to swing a bat for Dixie State. Remember, she had a bases-clearing double down the left field line early in game one that opened up that first inning. Now she'll have another chance to see what she can do here. Leaves it inside low, too low, ball one, Arista Honey. Two down. 3-1, Dixie State in the lead through five. Stierich on the inside corner, 1-1 now. The umpire liking that inside edge both ways. He's been rather generous all the way in there as well. First to Honey zones in, Ariana delivers, and it's too low. Ball two. Two balls, one strike. Ooh, watch her back foot. She barely gets it out of the way in time. Three balls, one strike. Arista Honey. And she gets a drive into one out towards left center. Left center gives chase with the left fielder there. Two hands, squeezes it, and that's just a long out for out number three as APU shuts Dixie down one more time. So we'll step aside for 1 minute after this replay, and we'll be back for the top half of the sixth. After five complete.
I take the road less traveled, run free, unwind, unravel. Someplace outside with lots to do. Green trees, red rocks, and don't forget that blue sky. The sunshine shining, fun shine, pouring on me. Think I might just stay a while. Say hooray all day because the sun is gonna shine on me. Sun is gonna shine on me. Sun's gonna shine on me.
You don't have to be so strong.
Strength is not optional. This is my mother, my purpose. Real muscle is lifting her spirits between bedpans and bad news from doctors that doubt her strength. Strength is buried in bills, managing meds, and swallowing those moments of, Mom, it's me, your daughter. Remember? My strength is super, but I'm still human, right?
Find support for your strength. Visit aarp.org/caregiving for care guides and community.
And we're back. Dixie State six outs away from taking the series with APU. But that's still a lot of work as Emily Moran steps up to the plate for APU. So APU came in 12-5 to this game in the Pac West. Dixie State 14-5. The winner of this game will jump back in front of the other in the PacWest Conference. Swung on, hit back up the middle, and that's going to get through. So Cheetah will have to hold on down as Emily Moran starts things off for APU with a single up the middle. Great piece of hitting there from Emily Moran. Sees one pitch and goes after it. Hits it right back up the middle for a single. Hard hit. Hard hit Emily Moran. Now Ariana Von Zabore going to step in and try to help herself, help her own cause right here. She's trying to pitch out of a jam as well. Comes in behind 3-1, and now she's got a 3-2 score back. And the pass ball will give the APU owner second base as Jessica Gonzalez thought it hit something, but it just went off of her glove. So Gonzo back behind the plate, runner on second now, as Ariana has a runner in scoring position to try to help her own cause here. Swung on, hit down the line. Look out, coach, right by you. My goodness. New teeth. One ball, two strikes. Two strikes on Ariana. Oh, 2. Brooklyn Beard cheered against the other pitcher. Ariana with a changeup, that's straight up in the air and called off by Mal. Mal squeezed it for the out. So one down, one runner on second. Pop out to the third base, or pop out to three, first base. One down. Now Aubrey gonna step in. She scored a run today already. The center fielder, number 18. And then she popped out to Josie. We'll see what she does here. Too low, ball one. The sun has decided it's gone and done for the day behind the clouds. That pitch on the outside edge just too much, though. Two balls, no strikes. That one got the edge, though. One ball, or two balls, one strike now to Aubrey. Beercher trying to get out of the sixth without giving the run, standing there on second to Emily. That one's going to go back up the middle as well. Now Cheetah has to come up and throw again. Scoop, and they hold her at third wisely, as Cheetah was not going to let someone else score on her from there. So another base hit right there by Aubrey. Another single moves the runner to third. And APU once again threatening with the top half of their lineup coming up. So they turn it over real quickly, real nice. And now it'll be Ileana Jimenez. Runners on the corners. Slapped down the left field line, and it'll be foul. Strike one. Big moment here for Dixie. Runners on the corners. Dixie State holding on to a one-run lead. One out. Dixie State could really use a double play ball or a strikeout here from Brooklyn Beardshear. Ileana Jimenez has other plans. Looking for a base hit to even things out here. Looking to bunt. She lays down a great bunt. And she beats it there. Ileana safe on the throw, so beats it down the line. Base is juiced, as I think that's the right call. Ileana got a great jump out of the bag there, out of the box. Let's take a look at it again. A great bunt. Kills it almost in the right spot. I mean, scoop, throw, one extra step, and I believe she was by her. That is the right call. Safe for Ileana Jimenez. Now, Kayla Bruchard. Kayla's hit one up the middle. About that same spot. They go four with it in time. Forced out for Jessica Gonzalez. So Josie Hartman scoops and throws home to keep the score where it is. Bases stay loaded. Bruchard gets another fielder's choice. Great pick and the throw in time, as Gonzalez had the right toe right on the corner of the plate. Almost went for a tag rather than holding the force, but it was close. So now, it all comes down to what can Nikki Sprague do. She's had a single and she's had a walk
at the plate, second base
so far today. Two of her three at plate appearances. Her other one, she rolled over to Bailey, and Bailey threw her out. So Brooklyn Beardshear looking to get out of another jam. Down in the dirt, Gonzalez stays in front of it and knocks it down. What a great dig there from Gonzalez. One ball. So Aubrey at third, Jimenez at second, Kayla Bruchard at first. And a 1-1 count. Swung on and hit out towards Shelby Young. Shelby gives chase. She's there, and that'll do it. So Dixie State gets out of a jam in the sixth inning. Holds them to no runs on a great play from Josie Hartman at short to throw him out at home. Here's the last one. I thought it might have got down, but Shelby and Cheetah both got a great jump on it, and Shelby brings it in. So Dixie State defense doing what they need to do. Now they go in and look for some insurance runs in the bottom half of the sixth. We'll step aside for 1 minute. We'll be back for the sixth inning.
Todd's a great guy. I mean, look at him. What a sweetheart. Attaboy. Wait, Todd. What are you doing? How totally selfish and un-Todd-like of you. Come on, Todd. Come on, man.
We cannot be bystanders.
We can stop to make sure someone is okay.
We can warn someone when their drink isn't safe.
And disrupt the situation.
We can
get someone the cab.
Or walk them home safely.
We can make campuses safer for our friends.
Our roommates,
our classmates,
our fellow human beings.
We cannot be bystanders.
We can
intervene.
It's on us,
all of us.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Came to get down. Jump up and get down. So Dixie State looking to see what they can do. Josie Hartman, who saved the run, and now going to have a chance to start the offense and get the offense going here in the sixth inning. It's been a back and forth game. APU with the advantage in the hits, Dixie State has the advantage in the errors, and they got three of them. But they're battling through the three errors to see what they can do here. First pitch inside corner called strike on that angle. Josie Hartman falls behind 0-1. Second pitch on the way from Ariana. Down in the dirt, ball one. 1-1 to Josie Hartman. Once again, Dixie State 3, Azusa Pacific 2 right there on your screen. That is correct. We're not crazy all the time. Sometimes gets a little out of hand. 1-1, Josie Hartman. Leave it up. Yes, she does. Two balls, one strike. As Dixie State trying to get something going. All their runs coming in the fourth inning, if I am correct. Yes. Fourth inning it was. That one's out to left field and retired goes Josie. Pop out to left. So one down, and it'll go back to the top of the order, right where you want to be if you're Dixie State. Sixth and seventh inning will come down to your lineup right where you want them. One out, as you see the replay, one, backed up a couple steps and stood under it. It'll be Cheetah. Once again, a ton of walks today. Hasn't really had a chance to get the bat off her shoulder. Seen a lot of balls, not many strikes. 1-2. The pop out for 3, 4, 5, 6 strikes that I have her down for that she's seen today in her 5 walks. There's 2 more balls to start off. 2-0. When you bat 488, you're not going to get a lot of chances to swing. She fouls one over towards the coach on third. Bounces off a pole hard right to the third baseman. Luckily, she's awake, and it goes right back to her. Two and one. Have the urge to sneeze, but it's not coming out, so I kind of am waiting for it. That pitch is too high. 3 balls, 1 strike, Cheetah. Cheetah hoping to get something. We're all hoping she gets something to swing at as well. We want to see her hit. She fouls one off. Oh, right through the legs of one of the players sitting on a bucket. Does a great job to get out of the way of it. The good news is the sneeze finally came. Now I can get back to announcing the game. Full count, Cheetah versus Ariana. She just steps in. She's seen 2 strikes this at bat, 5 the rest of the day. And she swings through 1, strike 3. Ariana gets the best of Cheetah this time. Only the 4th strikeout of the year for Janessa Bassett. Not an easy feat, so Ariana, what a great pitch there. Now it'll come to Danny Barthoff. Danny has walked, and hit a double and scored a run today for Dixie State. Her double was to the right center field, almost to the flagpole. We'll see what she does here. Could use some Danny Barthoff offense for Dixie State. If not, it'll be on the gloves of Dixie State to hold off the APU battle. That one's coming up to me. It's going to be right off our umbrella. Nope, off the roof, and then into the fans. I thought I was going to have a chance to make a play, but I didn't. 0-1 to Danny Barthoff. Second pitch on the way. Swung on and missed, strike 2. Ariana in a zone right now. Due up for APU when we go back. It'll be the 4-5-6 spot. So APU trying to get out of here and turn it over to their offense right in the middle of their lineup. And Dixie State trying to continue with 2 outs. 2 out rally looking here. 2 strikes. Danny Barthoff, outside edge too far. 1 ball, 2 strikes. So Dixie State looking to rally on 2, and APU looking to get back in with 2 outs. We'll see what they can muster up here. It's off the end of the bat. A little bit of miscommunication between first and second, but first baseman retires to the bag, and second scoops and tosses it out. So Danny Barthoff is retired. It'll go to the gloves of Dixie State. They need three outs. They're up 3-2, APU with their last chance. They got three outs left here in St. George to try to make a difference in the game. 3-2, Dixie State will be back with the top of the seventh inning in 1 minute.
Retired school psychologist, and helping people was my thing. After my stroke, when Meals on Wheels started, I was on the other end of the stick, so to speak, and I appreciated it very much, the attention that was given. My name is Julius Gaines, creative writer, poet, photographer. America, let's do lunch.
Drop off a hot meal and say hello. Volunteer by donating your lunch break at americaletsdolunch.org.
There is a place where looking out means looking in, where an impression lasting only a few seconds will be imprinted on a life forever, where courage is forged and innocence rediscovered, where remembering is rewarding and forgetting unforgettable. There is a place where truth is felt and where seeing is believing. There is a place.
And we're back. Dixie State, Carl Brooks Field, seventh inning. APU trails by one to Dixie State. Brooklyn Beardshire still in the circle. First pitch hit, and it'll be a base hit for APU. Leadoff on once again. APU been doing it all day long, putting leadoff people in position, just have not been able to score them. That's the second single in a row for Kayla Jimenez after she was robbed by Cheetah out in center field on a base hit. The lights are on and humming out here. And in St. George, got to bring up Jenna Gorman to the plate. Dixie State, like I said, chasing three outs here. They need three outs to end this game and take the series 3-1 versus APU. Jenna Gorman steps in with other plans as she'll try to even things up. Kayla, the leadoff with the first pitch, so they're going to try to move her. Mal scoops and goes second. It's going to be thrown out into center field. And Cheetah's now going to scoop, and she'll have to go to second. So the runner is now at third as Mal tried to make the tough play and go two on the bunt rather than just getting the one out at first. So there's now no outs. Runners on the corner for Dixie or for APU. As Mal thought she had more time than she did, and she unfortunately turned and threw it way too high as it got all the way out to Cheetah. So the fourth error of the day, kind of the story. Game three was error plagued for APU. This game they've been clean as can be, zero errors. And now infield way in, Coach Simpkins gonna take time. And looks like Brooklyn Beardshire's day will be done.
Let's hear it for Brooklyn Beardshire.
So she goes six full innings, and we'll see who they're gonna go to. Going back to Alexis. So nothing new for the hitters. They have seen Alexis all day in game three. Putting her in a tough spot here. Runner, tying run is on third. Simpkins kind of just wanted to talk to his infield about what happened. Tried to get the lead runner, not the wrong play. Just didn't work out for him as Paulson turned and wasn't able to get it down low enough for Josie there. So no outs, runners on the corner, Dixie State still with the one-run lead. The lead run is on first. If you can get her all the way across, they will take the lead, and Dixie State will come back to the plate, and they're right in the heart of their lineup. Mal, Jess, and Kenzie all due for something here in game three, or game four of the series, as Jess has struck out twice. Mallory has gotten a... She had a sack bunt to move a runner over, and then two pop outs. And Kenzie was hit by a pitch and then popped out twice as well. So if it does get to the point there. But let's just turn the defense up right here behind Alexis Barkwell and see if we can't get out of it without runners scoring. So runner at third, wouldn't be surprised to see anything they got from number 10. The last time number 10 was up, Erin Jaramillo, she hit one that didn't land inside the fence. However, it was foul. So inside pitch, low, ball one from Alexis. Erin then struck out after the ball she hit, so a mile. As Alexis is in a tough position here, APU gaining some momentum here in the seventh. Second pitch called strike, so 1-1, Alexis evens the count here. Second pitch, a little bit of a changeup up top, and the runners stay put. First and second, or first and third, pardon me, two balls, one strike. And another shot down that third base line. Oh, right in a guy's seat, and unable to bring it in. Ball in now, two balls, two strikes. Brooklyn's got to bring her best stuff right here. Alexis throws it in there, changeup, oh, and she sits on it. Cheetah gonna have to come in. That should be deep enough to score the run, and they'll hold the tag at second. It is deep enough to score, so APU ties the ball game with the sacrifice fly from Aaron Harmelo, who can really put the ball up in the air quite a ways. Sack fly scores it. We're all even here, 3-3 in the top half of the seventh inning, but APU still threatening with the runner on and only one out. So here's your replay. Alexis Barkwell gets a good changeup. Erin does everything she can to hold those hands back long enough, and does. Luckily, she wasn't expecting the changeup, or it could have been over. But it stays in play. So first pitch is fouled off down the first baseline by number 16, Emily Moran. And Emily Moran's been doing her thing. She had a single her last at bat, and then she was thrown out at home by Josie. One strike, one ball, one out. One run across so far. We got ourselves a 3-3 ball game here in St. George, Utah. APU battled back and foul ball straight back. APU took the lead early 1-0, and Dixie State answered back an inning later with three runs of their own, and now APU has had two innings where they've been able to push one more run across with the seventh inning pending to see if they can get more than one. Foul ball straight back again. Emily Moran now in the hole. One ball, two strikes. Once again, Jessica Gonzalez will be due up second, and she is due for a hit today for Dixie State. So stay tuned for that. If they can retire the next two. Two balls, two strikes. Alexis Barkwell going back to work here for Dixie State, trying to come in and get a save. See what the offense can do for her. Strike three, got her, two down. Gets her to swing through a high one as Alexis will now face Ariana. Ariana, the pitcher, gonna try to help her own cause, give herself some insurance here. With one swing of the bat, she can add two more for APU. Ariana has no home runs on the season though, with 15 hits. Outside, too much, ball one. Looked good from here, can't tell where it was on the screen. I was watching live rather than watching my screen, so I'm not sure where that one ended up, but it looked good over here, a little bit outside. This one hit up in the air, and there's gonna be room over there for Danny. Danny squeezes two hands, and that'll do it. So Dixie State gives up one in the top half of the seventh, ties it up 3-3, but due up now for your Trailblazers will be Mallory Paulson, Jess Gonzalez, and Kenzie Sawyer. Power, power, and power. We'll see what they can do. They need one to win. We'll be back in 1 minute to see the bottom half of the seventh.
Is a good day to be alive in the STG.
You would have lost your mind. I could not believe he
didn't. Southern Utah's connection to the world of sports is Sports Radio 97.7 ESPN. Southern Utah's home for the best in sports includes local high school games, Dixie State University, the NBA's new look, Utah Jazz, plus the best of the National Football League. With the worldwide presence of ESPN, to the Devin Dixon Show every afternoon from 4 to 6.
So, I just moved in with this family, and it's embarrassing. The little one, he likes to go outside and crawl around in the giant litter box. I don't know what he's doing. I mean, I was born, and I knew how to use the litter box. Look at that. That's disgusting. Oh, poop already. You're making me nervous. Oh, okay, I can't look at this anymore. I really hope he grows out of this, for his sake.
Number 24, Mallory Paulson.
Mallory Paulson going to be due up here. First batter, Ariana Stanton, to pitch. First pitch on the way. Mallory lets it go. Strike one. Oh-1. Mallory Paulson going against Ariana. Ariana with her back against the wall throws a strike and then a changeup for a ball. So 1-1. As Dixie State and APU battling all the way down in this four-game series to the last inning. All knotted up here, 3-3. Check swing right to first base, and she scoops and catches it in the air. So out number one. Now steps up the ever-dangerous Jessica Gonzalez, who is due. Mal Paulson with the line out to first. One down. Jess Gonzalez steps up to plate with a chance to get on base and give her team a chance. First pitch from Ariana. On the way. Gonzalez pops it straight up in the air. It's going to be too high. Shortstop calls everyone off, and she's under it, and she squeezes it for out number two. Two down, as Jessica Gonzalez just can't get it going offensively today. Pop out to six. Two down. Kenzie Sawyer looking to push things forward now for Dixie State here in the bottom of the seventh inning. Jessica Gonzalez just barely missed that one. And now Kenzie Sawyer, 00. With a chance to be the hero for the day. Ball one. Not a bad spot behind her either, the red hot Bailey Gaffin. Once again, she's been on base twice today in the second game. Sawyer sees one across the waist, and Ariana has gotten faster. I feel like she's gotten faster every inning she's pitched. Not losing any steam on what she's throwing. It's getting in there quick. One ball, one strike. Leaves it up a little bit. Outside, two balls, one strike. Kind of a floating change there, kind of off speed a little bit to get Kenzie thinking a little bit more than she probably wants to. Inside corner, too much. So three balls, one strike to Sawyer. If they put her on, I wouldn't be surprised to see some more speed. So full count, works it to full. Now it's a payoff pitch. Sawyer got to have something to hit unless they want to walk her. Probably don't want to walk her in this situation. The payoff pitch for Ariana on the way. Sawyer lays off, and it's a walk. So Sawyer going to get on there on base, does a great job, works count full, and draws a walk. And that'll bring up Bailey Gaffin. Coach Simpkins going to dig deep into the lineup and send a runner. And it's going to be number 10. I believe that's Taylor Godfrey. So Taylor going to step in and run for Kenzie Sawyer. Does her job, gets on base. And now Bailey Gaffin starts over. Zero balls, zero strikes, two outs. Bottom of the seventh inning for Dixie State. First pitch, strike called up top corner of the strike zone. And here goes Bailey Gaffin. 0-1. Swings and fouls it off. 0-2, Bailey Gaffin in a hole. It's a nice thing about baseball and softball, though. It takes three of them to get you out, so she's still alive. So Bailey Gaffin digs in, waits for the 0-2 pitch. See what they go with. Outside edge, too much. Godfrey takes second, so Godfrey in scoring position. If Bailey Gaffin can put one to the grass, it'll be enough for Dixie State. As plenty of wheels from Godfrey, swipes the bag. Great play. I think the catcher got caught sleeping a little bit. And Taylor Godfrey takes second. Throwdown was there, but it was well late. So the 1-2. Gaffin goes up top, fouls it off, has to fight it off. Great job to get a barrel on it. Staying alive. Runner at second. That's Godfrey. Stole second there. Now she's got a chance. On contact, Gaffin is moving. Anything in front of her, she'll have to watch out for. But anything behind her, she's going and picking up Coach Simpkins and see what he says. Gaffin sends one out to the gap. That's going to do it. Bailey Gaffin with the walk-off double. Bailey Gaffin wins it for Dixie State. And Dixie State will take the series 3-1 on the walk-off shot to opposite field, right, the left center gap. What a shot for Bailey Gaffin. Red hot, and she stays there with an RBI double walk-off. Miss Gaffin. Let's take a look at it. Throws the hands, takes it, hit it where it's at, as Coach Simpkins always says, all fields, all speeds, and they get it done. So Dixie State goes ahead and wins 2 games today against APU. For the first time, they've won 2 straight now. For the first time in about since March 15th, since they've won 2 games in a row at the same school. So that'll move Trailblazers to 15-5 for the PacWest play and 12-6 for Azusa Pacific. Dixie State goes to UNLV on March 29th. And then they'll be back home on April 8th against Notre Dame Day Namar for a doubleheader at noon. A great game by your Dixie State Trailblazers to pull out the win. And they win 3-4 on the weekend for a great series. And it should move them into better position for the PacWest Championship. Once again, they play next Wednesday, March 29th at UNLV, and then they come back home on April 8th for a doubleheader against Notre Dame Day Namar. Then they hit the road for 8 straight. Concordia Irvine on April 14th, Concordia Irvine on April 15th, and then April 21st and April 22nd. The next week, they are at Cal BAP for two games on the 21st and 2 games on the 22nd, and then they will come home and end their season on April 29th versus the Academy of Art on a doubleheader starting at noon. So once again, this is Hayden Peterson with CECTV, an exciting finish from Dixie State, and we are glad to be here, glad to be able to bring it to you through YouTube and CECTV. And that's all we've got. Signing out, Hayden Peterson, CECTV. We'll catch you next time.